I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered. Behind.
You and I have faced worse, Professor.
Search the area! Must be here somewhere.
We must be getting closer.
Renrock will be pleased with our progress.
Renrock's vision of goblins ruling over wizards will be fulfilled.
That's the way forward.
Don't perceptive, my young. It worked. Let's go.
Lumos!
Ranrok must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor.
Listen, Morgon.
It's the students! And
fools of a feather!
Getting closer, Professor. That way.
Somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Steer them this way! We shall make quick work of them!
Oh. They got this.
Look out! Another troll!
The wand! Quickly!
We got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isadora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I've decided to open the repository. Its power cannot lie dormant for centuries more.
After everything you've seen, what about Isadora's fate?
Isadora knew she had a remarkable power to help people. I intend to use my ability to finish her work, build upon it.
But this could go wrong in so many ways. You, of all wizardkind, are wholly aware of the potential cost.
I also know the promise, Professor. With all I have learned, I can avoid making the same mistakes Isadora did. I can learn to wield this magic for good.
Arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you were two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either.
To no one!
Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly, and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
Please meet me as soon as possible.
Never imagined we'd attend a funeral for one of our professors. Glad Weasley spoke for Fig. She honored him. He'll be well remembered. I only wish we could have done the same for Solomon Sallow. I need to go and see Anne soon.
Ominous, there's something I need to tell you. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if you faced quite a fight.
The rumor's true, and I did. But it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait, what are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrock's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Victor Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
You see, since Feldcroft was of interest to Ranrock, it became of interest to Rookwood as well. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrock. When he saw Anne, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her. Oh, so cruel. Rookwood got what he deserved. Thank you for telling me. Anne and Sebastian deserve to know, and it should come from me. As we discussed, I spoke with Black. Sebastian's with the headmaster now, but perhaps there's a way to get word to him. When I find out, I'll send an owl.
prepare to approach the centaurs about protecting the Snidgets. Meet me in the Forbidden Forest.
I have news about Sebastian. Meet me in the Undercroft as soon as you can.